Glad to be with you on this, the first
Friday
in October.
Welcome.
We're going into the last quarter of the year.
Yes, the last quarter.
We are grateful to have you on with us tonight.
Yes, we are. Yes, we are.
Good evening, Mother Henson.
Hey, Mother Henson. Hey, Mommy.
Good evening, Ma. Good to have you on with us tonight. And can y'all do us a favor? We got like 10... We only got like 15 people on tonight, so can y'all help us?
Share, add some people
to the broadcast tonight.
Share, please share. We would love to have as many people on as possible tonight.
All the numbers are climbing. Good. Spread the word. Late Night with the Harvins is on for Friday, October the 2nd.
Yes.
And we welcome you. Took last Friday. We missed you because we were traveling to Cleveland to celebrate the life of Papa Ellis,
yes.
Bishop Jesse Delano Ellis, Metropolitan of the Joint College, African-American Pentecostal bishops, to stand with our sister in faith and beloved friend of many years, Pastor Sabrina Ellis, and their children and his family as we celebrated his life and sent him home.
Here we go.
In kingdom royal fashion as a prince of the church. And I was thinking that we should broadcast live from the airport, but I didn't think it would be cute. So here we are tonight, and we're back for another edition of Late Night with the Harvins. Late Night with the Harvins. Glad that you're on with us.
Yes.
And all right. So what are we talking about tonight?
Well, there's so much that we can talk about. How about those debates? Okay, they were quite interesting. I'm just saying, there's so much that we could talk about when we think about what's happening in the world right now, and what's happening in our country right now, what's happening literally in D.C. right now and in Maryland right now with the 45th occupant. It's just so much we could talk about. But we thought tonight, I don't know how many of you have seen these commercials, but there are commercials out right now. I think it's by Dole.
It's by Dole.
And it talks about fruit bowls and how...
Y'all don't know how many times she rewinds this commercial to watch it.
I just love the commercial.
Good evening to the Zimmermans. Glad to have you on.
Hey.
So, Pastor Z and First Lady Z.
Hey,
good to have you on, Auntie Tanny.
Hey, Tanny.
Glad to have you on, Marcus, the guy who keeps your car shining and clean.
Hey, yes, if you want your car detailed, he's your guy. He's amazing.
Keeps your car shining and sparkling.
Absolutely.
Mine are sparkling right now. It's been
raining all week. We need you.
It's been raining all the weekend. It's got gray stuff.
And, yes.
It's a mess. Yes. All right. So
fruit bowls.
We really going to talk about fruit bowls?
Okay, we don't have to.
I didn't want to talk about it.
What do you want to talk about?
I don't know, but fruit bowls, really?
It's just an interesting, the commercials, I think Dole is a genius in how they're marketing these fruit bowls that
I'm not touching stuff. See, there it is.
Okay, leave it alone. So why does it look like that over there?
Because that's 10 seconds behind. It's going to show it, what you see over there. You're going to see over here.
Bishop Harvin, my husband, Kevin Harvin III.
That was not me.
He's so techie.
We're back. It wasn't my fault.
It wasn't his fault. So anyway, back to the fruit bowls. Dole has these commercials out.
Advertising.
Yeah, he's a mass media major.
Yeah. Mine in PR and advertising, but it's not.
Yes, so advertising fruit bowls. And one of the commercials.
It's a nice concept.
It is really a great concept. So there is a African-American couple. And they are older than us, right?
They're grandparents,
and they have their granddaughter, and they talk about fruit bowls. And for them, fruit bowls is like
it's a code word.
Code word for, you know, just having some intimacy time, some time, you know, with couples. But the grandmother, she says, you know, I love fruit bowls, and we're having fruit bowls. No, what is she? How does she say it?
She says,
some of us are.
The grandfather says, so would you like to have a fruit bowl? And she said, yes, I'd like to have a fruit bowl. And then the granddaughter overhears the conversation. She said, can I have a fruit bowl too?
Right. And so the grandma says,
We're eating a lot of fruit bowls, but we're not having a lot of fruit bowls.
And it just tickled me.
I'm just trying to tell you.
It tickled me.
She thinks this commercial is the funniest thing.
It tickled me
since Whoopi Goldberg walked across the stage dressed up like that little old lady. Hey, Deacon Kevin Hill.
So I absolutely love the commercial, and I thought about it, and I said that's quite interesting. So most couples have like a code word or a phrase or something that, you know, says, hey, you know, whatever it means, they have something between them that means something totally different than to the normal person or the average person. And at least I hope they do. Mm-hmm. Why are we still doing this?
You're still on. You're live.
Okay.
I'm just adding you to.
Okay. So I just think it's an amazing commercial. And it just makes me laugh and makes me smile, because how many couples out there feel like, you know, when you get interrupted, you have young people at your home or your grandparents, your grandchildren are at your home, or even, you know, other people at your home. And, you know, you're like, I really would love to have a fruit bowl right now, but I can't have a fruit bowl. But, you know, then, you know, I just think it's a great commercial. That's just me. What do you
All
think?
Right, great. I thought it was cute too.
Thank you, Keisha Joyce.
I thought it was an amazing commercial. No, I don't.
But I love the commercial, and I was like, oh, that's so cute. Like, you know.
Pam is laughing.
Yes, Pam, I think it's a great thing. And I think at this point in our lives, honestly, right now where we are on, what is this, October?
October 2nd, 2020. 10 yes. to 20.
10 to 20.
We 10 need some, times 2 equals 20.
We need some brevity right now. It's been such a...
Some levity.
Levity. Thank you. Yeah, we need some levity. I know what it means. Levity. We need some laughter. We need something humorous, something, you know, because there's so much seriousness right now. There's so much going on that can wear you out. I don't know about you, but, you know, that debate just gave me a headache. And it just, I mean, we were up and we just were like, what is happening right now in our country? And now today, yesterday, and today, it's like, so we need some levity. So I thought, why not, you know, keep
let's
it
talk
light.
About fruit bowls. Let's so how's your fruit bowl bowls. Life?
Yes, how is your fruit
how's
bowl
your
life?
Fruit bowl life?
How is your fruit bowl life? I hope your fruit bowl life is
I
fruitful.
Hope you have a healthy fruit bowl life.
Yes. Yes. Anybody want to share about their fruit bowl life?
Nobody's going to share about
their fruit bowl life. Not details, but you know that it's healthy, that it's you know, it's happening. And
by show of hands, how many people feel like the grandmother in the commercial? That there are not enough fruit bowls being served in life.
Right.
Non-existing. Oh, my savior.
Oh, well, yeah.
Kevin, Erica. What does stupid mean? What's stupid? Your fruit bowl life?
I hope not.
Oh, stupid as an extreme over the top. Is that what you, I think that's what you meant. You.
Oh,
probably,
okay. Yes. You were that using sounds as like a you street accent.
Yeah, I had to think about who was posting on the screen.
Right.
All right.
So initially we were going to talk about mental health tonight. But because of all that has transpired, we just thought we would keep it light. Yes, you will when you get married. Absolutely, Keisha. I touch and agree with you.
No, I got one better than that. Mother Henson put up, fruit, it does a body good.
Yes, Mother. Next yes, coming mother, from the mothers through. Of the house. Mothers.
Now, how many, Mother, how many years have you and Pop been married? Pop Henson and Mother Henson have been married, I think, for like 58 years.
50-something, I know that.
58 years? I mean, I can't remember the exact number. Mother, I know she's typing it in now. They've been married, fruit bowling, for how many
I
want to
say 57 or 58, or it might even be 59. But it's been a long time, so that's wisdom.
Well, good evening, Rita Cooper. She's Rita 51 Cooper. Years. 51. So Mother, Mom and Pop Henson have been married for 51 years. So take it from a 51-year bride that fruit bowls do a body good. Fruit bowls
yes,
do a body good.
Yes, they do.
Good evening. So I told you Rita Cooper was on. Good evening to Toot and Andy tuning in with us tonight. Glad to have you with us. We're talking to Tootie tonight about fruit bowls. Fruit bowls.
I know you're like, what? Fruit bowls.
Fruit bowls.
So yeah, just and I think more than anything, it's about just keeping some fun in your life. And I think that's a form of intimacy, you know, just that code word. What do you think?
Oh yeah, just to be able to have your own code language. I think that it is a form of intimacy. It also serves the role as your own unique preparatory language.
Okay, I like it.
It's like the appetizer. So before the fruit bowl, there's an appetizer, and appetizers can be served all day long.
Right, right. That's good. Okay, so, all right. I mean, we're not going to talk all night about fruit bowls because what else is there to say about fruit bowls? What else?
We can talk.
What do you want to say?
We can talk about the crisis. The crisis in fruit bowls in the land where fruit bowls are meant to be healthy. Fruit bowls are meant to be helpful and wholesome, but people are using fruit bowls. People are using for fruit bowls for everything. In some instances, are using it for things that fruit bowls were never meant to be used for.
That's good, sir.
You know, fruit bowls were never meant to be used to mix with sand in the sandbox. And Dante speaks, I'm going to send you to time out because he says, and flavorable.
Oh, no.
Flavorful.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. So I'm going to send you to the time out. And so, amen. And so I think that one of the things that I appreciate about the commercial is that it brings front and center models or examples of fruit bowls in their appropriate context. And I believe that especially for people who are able to identify what the illustration, what the parallel really is, I'm going to slap Dante Linwood speaks. The next time I see you, I'm going to hit you in the back of your head.
Lord.
You don't throw fruit bowls across the table.
That's good.
But I think that to my original point, I appreciate the imagery and the way it's situated for those that understand the illustration of the language. It in some small way reclaims that aspect of what God has given us as human desire and human reality, brings it back to something wholesome and clean.
Absolutely.
And helps many people in some generations to get over their hangups. I don't know why you can't talk freely about something so normal, so healthy, so God-given, can't talk freely about it and get over your hangups about it. Fruit bowls, in the words of Mother Henson tonight, they do a body good.
Absolutely. And I love that if they portray a senior couple, because it you know, for me, it just lets me know that, you know, just because you get older doesn't mean, you know, things end. I mean, you can continue and enjoy life, you know, as a senior, as a grandparent. So I loved that they didn't use, you know, a millennial, you know, but that they used a baby boomer, you know, boomer couple. I love that.
There's three different versions of that. No, I think it's actually four.
But
they're good. And so if you haven't seen them, you can search for it on YouTube. They all come up. Now, I'm appreciating Marilyn Stewart's comment. She writes, for those of you who can't see what she's posting on Facebook because you're viewing on the other social media platform. She writes, "I'm glad it's being discussed because men had to initiate a long time ago. Now women are comfortable wanting and asking for
fruit too. Yes, that's absolutely
bowls.
True.
Asking for fruit bowls too.
Yeah, that's correct.
Bowl. Code language is fruit bowl, you know.
Right. Yeah, and I to your point, that's tremendous that again, that commercial, I think it's so forward thinking because it does display that. I mean, historically, it is the man who initiates, and that commercial, you know, kind of empowers and frees women to initiate what's happening.
So Dante just posted, and the fruit bowl should be fresh, not frozen. I understand. I don't know
what that means.
And so Dante says older couples will get that. And I guess that must mean people older than 30, because we're 30 years old as a couple. And I'm completely clueless what you mean by the difference. I mean, I know that, but I don't know. But in this context, I have to catch up. Now, I'm looking, Tootie, you said you're completely lost. And so I'm going to give you a pass because I know that you're commuting between two cities. So there's a Dole commercial, and the Dole commercial, fruit bowls. Mother Henson doesn't know what you're talking about either, Dante. So it must be for people that's been married for 60 years or more, the difference between fresh fruit bowls and frozen fruit bowls.
I mean, maybe
we're clueless.
Maybe
we're
he's clueless. Saying that you don't want to. I don't know. I'm trying to help you, Dante.
I can't come around the bend. But Annette, do the YouTube search for the Dole advertising campaign about fruit bowls and how it's code language for couples. It's code language. Yes. And that's what we're talking about. That's what, you know, your sister wanted to talk about.
I did. I just thought,
you talk about fruit bowls. It's a cute little topic, but the fact of the matter is, we should be able to speak about it
without using code words.
I think the code language is helpful to at least get the conversation to the table.
True.
To have the conversation that maybe we don't have fruit bowls often enough, or I'm tired of the fruit bowls that's just got pears and scoops of grapefruit. You know, some, because, you know, you go in the store and the fruit bowls, you can get some that are pineapple centered and others have cherries and some don't. And then you can find some that have peaches and some that the fruit bowl is just peaches in the bowl. And so, you know, the question is whether or not there is variety.
But at the end of the day, I mean,
in the fruit bowl you select.
I think, Bishop, I do believe that conversations need to be had, especially for couples. I mean, and when we think about in the church, we think about in our families, you know, talking about sex is a taboo. It's not something that people want to, like,
this is a family show.
Oh, okay. But, you know, people don't want to talk about it. And I think it's important that you do talk about it, because a lot of people fall in down rabbit holes and pits in marriages because they're not having healthy conversations about, you know, their sexual lives. And it's so important.
So we have people speaking up, not only pairs and group truths. And I want you to understand that Dante comes to give us an explanation about fresh is always better for you than frozen. No additives. Pick it right off the tree. And I can use that and keep it theologically sound, that just because it's picked from the tree doesn't mean it's right for consumption at that time. And one of the things I believe is true in this age is you have people who are picking from the tree, they get it home and they are indulging in said fruit before the fruit is in its time, before it's ripe. You know, you got to have, I think my grandmother used to say it this way, you need to know somebody for four seasons.
That's right.
Before it's ripe for consumption. And then to that same end, Annette Soto says some fruits are seasonal. All right. And so, I mean, is it possible what you think that is it possible that there's some things in our fruit bowl lives that is your fruit selection sweeter at some points in the year than others? Are there some fruits that are more prevalent in other periods of the year than others? You know, it's easier to how do I want to say this? Sometimes you might be in the mood for fruit and you want something that's easier access than, let's say, a pineapple. A pineapple requires some preparation and some work in order to get to. Over and again, nobody just gets up and says, oh, I'm going to go have me a piece of fruit. And you go run downstairs and start slicing a pineapple because that requires some work. And then other times you say, I'm going to give me a piece of fruit. You go grab the apple and you're on your way, or you go grab the banana, you peel it and you're on your way.
Okay. So I think that it's very important. Again, that talks about.
How about that?
I think that talks about communication. I think it's important that both people, you know, are satisfied. You know, so, I mean, you may want a quick couple of grapes and your partner may not want that. Your partner may want a whole fruit salad. So then how do you know, you have to be able to discuss it, because if not, then somebody's leaving the table frustrated. Somebody's leaving the table feeling a certain kind of way. So I think it's important. And if that continues, then, you know, you could have some trouble later. You know?
But what if the ingredients to the fruit salad are not in season? And that, how do we get over it?
That's where communication comes.
Okay.
I think that's where you have to have those courageous conversations and be really transparent with your spouse, your mate, and say, hey, you know, this is where I am. I think it's important that we have those healthy, transparent, courageous conversations. Sometimes it's not, it's not always easy, because you know, you're laying yourself out there and you have to be vulnerable, but I think it's important. It's worth it to invest in your relationship, to be honest and say, hey, it's not that time.
So there's the conversation challenge coming from Lisa to say that maybe this might be a nice entry point and say, let's talk about fruit bowls.
Let's talk about it.
Let's talk about fruit bowls, and let's talk about what are the ingredients of the perfect fruit bowl for us. Let's talk about what are the ingredients for the perfect fruit bowl for us. Somebody leaving the table unfruitified.
Right.
The back of your head is going to have some bruises.
I'm going to get you, Dante. But honestly, that's real.
The back of your head is going to have some
bruises. A lot of couples, you know, they deal with that, and they deal with it silently. They don't share. They don't talk about it. You know, they roll over and go to sleep, and they're frustrated. Let's just be real.
So Dr. Whitehead, Siobhana Whitehead, just said to us that sometimes you have to be open to try new fruit.
That's good. That's good, Doc.
And I want to suggest to you this is very important, underscoring the whole notion of trying new fruit. You have to be careful to make sure that there are no allergies against. Oh yeah, Holy Spirit whispered that when I read it. I was like, wow.
You don't want allergic reactions.
You don't want an allergic reaction, especially if you already have existing allergy to some things. If it's something that you've not been introduced to prior, you're not sure how it's related in the whole fruit world to something else that you are allergic to. Like I am allergic to coconut. And one time we were in Jamaica and I think it's called star fruit.
That's star the shape fruit. Of
it. Mm-hmm. And it is some kind of, it's a distant cousin of coconut. And so I didn't have a severe reaction, but I had one. And so we had to put that on the list of allergies. So when you're trying new stuff, just make sure that you check the origins of it. Yeah,
again, it goes back to another meaning there. Communication.
It
goes back to you have to have healthy communication. I mean, it's imperative. It's vital.
Mm-hmm.
Don't you think?
Having the discussion will bring you closer together since you are willing to be open
absolutely
to the conversation. I agree with you, Carmelita. And I think that is really for many relationships. 80% of the challenge or the battle, just getting the conversation started. And maybe just having the conversation of, I'm gonna take an empty bowl and we're gonna make a fruit bowl and we're gonna you and I determine the recipe of this fruit bowl that's going to, Dante Speaks term, going to fruitify our relationship.
Fruitify. Come on, Speaks. I'm going to use that. Fruitify.
I'm not going to use it. That was the one time I'm going to use it.
I'm going to use it, Dante. Thank you.
That's the one time.
You also can't what?
Buy any brand of fruit and know where it's from. Hmm. Well, yeah. You just got to make sure they ain't putting no pesticide on the skin or make sure you wash it good before consumption.
So if you haven't seen the commercial, I encourage you to watch it because it is so endearing.
She is so, I mean, I think she really owes Dole a tithe.
It's endearing. It's really endearing. Again,
it warms your heart.
It does. And in the age of, what was that God-forsaken video that, in the age of WAP, it is endearing. It is so endearing to me. Like I just, you know, it is.
I just left the building. Thank you so much for tuning
in. I'm serious.
Thank you so much for tuning in to Late Night with the Harvin.
It is just.
But Deron Harvin just left the building.
Stop it.
Do you understand? She woke me up at 5:30 in the morning.
It was traumatizing for me.
And made me watch this here video about WAP. If you don't know what it means, live in the bliss in this instance, live in the bliss of ignorance. Live in the bliss of ignorance.
Right.
Because you can't unsee it once you see it. You can't unsee it. You can't unsee
at
it.
All.
I'm just trying to
so that commercial to me is unsee it's it. Just endearing.
It's just Jaleesa said, I just hollered. I will say to you, and I'll share this with my late night with the Harvins family. So you'll have a headlines of some things between now and the end of the year. There's a section in that song that's going to show up in a message that I'm working on because I saw some a spiritual parallel between it and the church. And it's a section in there where there's a little cadence piece going where the dudes are in the background. There's some and I was like, yeah, but it's a different kind of. And so y'all, and if you don't know the song, you don't know what I'm talking about. But hey, man, it's gonna be every now and then go back and try a piece of fruit you used to not like. Our taste buds evolve.
Yes,
man. Now.
Absolutely. Our palate does change. Yes.
Now.
That's good.
And in the context of marriage, this is especially for young couples. Let me say this to younger couples and the more seasoned couples that are on with us tonight. Y'all can chime in and tell me whether or not you agree. But my experience, and I'm just talking my experience with fruit bowls, is there are some things you did not have a proclivity or preference for early on when you first got introduced to fruit bowls. But as the years have grown and the intimacy, not the fruit bowl life, but the intimacy life,
right,
has grown life and nurtured and developed, there are some things that used to make you cringe that now are simply an extension and expression of the love that has grown and developed and evolved in the relationship over time. And I say that especially for younger couples, because if I've had one, I've had two couples that is something that comes up in conversation or in counseling sessions from time to time. Well, he won't do this or she won't do that. And it's not that I don't love her or I don't love him. It is an issue of not a level of readiness or having evolved to a place of comfort. And the trust factor has not grown to that level. Not that there isn't trust. It just hasn't grown to hold that bird's nest on its branches.
There's all right. There it is.
All right.
That's an absolute intimacy.
That's evolution. Good. Intimacy evolution is necessary. Shavonna, let me just tell you what I know. If every other aspect of the relationship is growing and the intimacy is stunted,
wow,
eventually the relationship will stumble.
Die. Yeah,
it will stumble. And if you can't get it standing back up, it'll die. Death will be imminent at some point. The fact of the matter is, whatever we don't nurture dies.
Right.
Whatever we don't nurture doesn't grow.
That's for sure.
All right. Okay. Now let's see what we have here. I really wish that I had given. I knew we were gonna go down this road and talk about, because it would have been nice to bring on my young. I've got one of my young, really young couples on tonight. I would love to bring them on to talk about fruit bowls. Taylor and TC. I would love to have a conversation with them about fruit bowls.
That would have been nice.
That would have been very intriguing.
Get a millennial.
To do a juxtaposition between the fruit bowl commercial and the WAP video, to just kind of see the mindset of someone. Because see, for somebody like me, who is still young, but not necessarily a prude. But the fact of the matter is, the WAP video was a little much for the saint. I'm just trying to tell you, I'm gonna own it. It was a little much for me, but still open-minded and progressive and thinking. I would love to hear how that is filtered through the lens of somebody in their 20s and what they see, what it makes them feel, both from the female and the male perspective.
Hmm.
Especially in the age of Me Too, I think that, you know, any woman that is not offended by that video, I would really love to know why, at the way it objectifies women, really, really unashamedly. What you say, you know, we have old souls. That's true, too. I have to. Taylor said that, you know, we have old souls. You and TC, just old people in young bodies.
Alexis.
All right.
Hey, Alexis.
Hey, Alexis.
Hey.
Alexis
North
know
Carolina
about
in the house.
Alexis
know about fruit bowls.
Got them babies.
Yes. Yes, married. Oh, married.
Those babies like fruit bowls too. Y'all having fruit? Y'all eating fruit bowls, but y'all not having no fruit bowls.
Right.
They sleeping in the crib. They on beds yet?
Yeah. Listen, put them babies in their own beds.
Yes, sir.
Don't do that. Experience
is the best teacher. We've had the experience so that you don't have to. When we had our first child, Durant was the hardest kid to get out of the bed. And trust and believe, when Daria and Devin came along, I don't think they got the privilege of sleeping in the master bedroom. No, bowls, baby, bowls. B-O-W-L-S, not fruit bowls. Bowls, bowls. B-O-W-L-S. You don't watch the Dole commercials? I forgot.
She's a young mother.
You're a young mother. You don't have time to watch TV. I get it. Oh, yes. They have bunk beds. My husband don't play that.
I know.
Your husband is a wise man.
He's so smart.
Your husband's a wise man. And I'll tell the brothers from Jump Street, I know when you had your first child and it's old and your heart is warm, but do yourself a favor from day one. Say, nah, dude, nah, sis, you can't sleep in here. No, 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 no. No, 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 no.
They're laughing at you.
Oh, my spelling is challenged, baby. I'm glad it's just your spelling because I was getting concerned about you.
Lord, help me. help me.
I was thinking I had to take North Carolina with some oil and pray for you. Tyrone, you never had that issue?
Oh, we did. Oh, it was terrible.
We had that issue. He screamed and hollered and banged on doors. Then he found the shortcut through the closet. It was ridiculous. And then when you fuss at him, what did I do?
So, make sure young couples out there, keep your children in their own beds, put them in them cribs. They'll be fine. Trust me, they will be absolutely fine. But it's really important that you cherish those moments, create your own spaces. Create some boundaries, even with your children. You got to have some boundaries, right?
You got to have some boundaries. So now let's hear from you so we can try to, mix it up a little bit more. What are the greatest challenges that couples are facing today? What are your greatest challenges to having attractive and energizing and enticing fruit bowls? Let's see what you just said right there, Alexis. I didn't see it. They sneak in early in the morning sometimes. I don't mind, but they daddy, he has no mercy.
Good for him. They'll be fine.
All I can say is everybody said, hey, look them straight in the eye and say, daddy needs some fruit. All right. That don't work because they'll go down the hallway into the pantry. They'll get you a Dole fruit cup and come back with five spoons. Don't even try it. Don't even this generation. They're not hearing that. You can look them in their eyes if you want to. They'll look you back in your eyes and roll theirs and say, move out the way, man.
Challenges with that dried fruit. Okay. So let's talk about that. Why are you making that face? You asked the question. He asked the question. Now he's making faces when he gets questions. Come on.
I'm not making faces. I just wasn't expecting it. We had time getting. Oh, dear. All right. So now here's a wonderful question. Challenges with dried fruit. So I'm not exactly sure how to address that. But the ladies over here on the other platform are suggesting, and I'm quoting here, drink water, sis, KY, sprinkle some sugar on it. Those are the comments from over yonder. The reality, those are the comments from over yonder. Now let me give you my official answer. That's the contributions from the community. And what I would say, kind of backing into it, is these are the kinds of conversations that are necessary as we age. And as we age, the best action is proaction.
Right.
The best action is proaction. And there are things that should be and can be done in order to maintain.
She said she was being fine.
Both the rehydration and the efficacy of said fruit bowls. Amen. Because, you know, nobody likes a mushy banana.
But again, it's all about conversation. I think, again, if you are, and I know, you know, and that you said you were being funny, but for some people, they're not courageous enough to say anything. But if you are in that place, I think, again, it's important to have a conversation and say, you know, talk about your bodies with one another, because as we grow older, things do change. And it is important that you don't, you know, have any shame. That you're not shaming yourself, you're not shaming your spouse or your significant other, but that you are able to talk about, this is what's happening in the changes that are going on in my body. I don't understand it. I don't like it, blah, 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 whatever. But talk about it together instead of trying to deal with it on your own or hide it. You know, I think that's a wonderful opportunity to talk about.
And I want to push it just a little bit further to say, talk about it, get it out in the open, and then do something about it.
Together.
Do something right. about it. Whether that is changing diet, increasing right. exercise, going to the doctors,
right.
and realize that you know everybody's path is different.
Right.
And when you discover the correction that works for you, walk it out. Walk it out. And what about a good physician recommendation, especially for AA people?
African-American.
What about good physician recommendation, especially for AA people?
Are you asking us for a recommendation, or are you just putting out there that is important to have a good physician, especially as African-Americans, which is absolutely paramount.
I'm not really prone to recommend a specific physician, but I'm going to underscore what I believe is the spirit of the question. That is to say, some of these things are brought on not because of the fruit bowl action, but because of some other medical condition
Absolutely.
That has gone unaddressed and can be addressed. And once you correct it, everything else kind of gets back in alignment. The reality is that many times, and I'll just speak from this vantage point, because I can't speak for African American women because I've never been one, but I'm going to say from the vantage point of African American men, because I am one and know quite a few, probably 50% of my friends really have an aversion to going to the doctors for whatever reason.
Right.
And I'm not part of that group. I'm of the mindset, if you spend money for health insurance, you and your physician ought to be on first name basis. I mean, I don't believe in changing physicians every 3 months or just going to the patient first. I mean, maybe when you're in your 20s and 30s, that may be all right. I'd still turn my nose up at that. But by the time you are 40 years old, definitely when you have entered your 50s, you and your doctor should have a relationship
Yes.
that's at least a decade old, because you need someone that's able to track your trends, track your milestones, so that if there is a developing problem, if there are family history issues, you can get ahead of that. You can get ahead of that.
Yes.
And when you have a good physician, now somebody who just comes in and all they do is write prescriptions and they don't have conversations with you about your lifestyle, about what's going on, and they only in the room with you for 3 and 4 minutes, and then you get an $800 bill for that visit, fire her. You need someone who's going to really take some interest with you. And 15, 20 minutes later, some real ground has been covered. Some
Yes.
recommendations have been
Yes.
made. And then if you see this is how you know you have a keeper. If you have a physician that follows up with you after your appointment, that's somebody you keep. If
Yeah.
you and someone who takes seriously your concerns. I remember when the blood pressure issue, the numbers started to come out of order about 10, 15 years ago for me. My doctor's name is Kevin Carter. He said to me, look, I want you to think about this. You need to get moving. You need to do this, because what I don't want to do is to put you on these pills. And so we had that conversation. And then he said, now, because I know you, and you up there screaming and howling, jumping around, you still running around the church? I'm going to be running around the church when I'm 75 years old. I got saved and ran around the church. And so I'm just running around the church as just part of my salvation process. And he said, so that you don't run around the church and blow a blood vessel, this is what you need to be working on. And now all these years later, to be able to go to the doctor's, you know, 2, 3, 4 times a year.
Right.
And he says, oh, you got great numbers here. And then he pulls up stuff on the screen, says you're ahead of the curve right here. And the fact that high blood pressure, hypertension, my father had it, his mother before him had it. And at 54, that's how old I am, at 54, I'm not facing the things my father faced at 54. That is the grace of God, the good sense that my mama and my God gave me. And then number three, a doctor who keeps staying in my ear. So to Sister Marilyn's point, it's important to have a good physician. And when you talk about your fruit bowl health, to be fructified, that is a conversation you have to have freely and fully, not only with your medical professional, but also with your mental health professional.
Listen,
because some people's hangups in the bedroom have nothing to do with the equipment. It has everything to do with the emotions. Talk to me right
there. That's good. That's so good.
It has everything to do with the emotion.
Everything to do with it. So it is important to have a healthy relationship with a mental health professional, so that you can share, so that you can talk, so that you can, you know, share your fears, share your hangups, share the stuff that, you know, you dealt with 20 years ago, or happened to you 20 years ago, that's impacting you in your present right now. So yeah, it's really important. It's really important. And to go back to the physician, your medical doctor, if you don't have a doctor that you can freely talk about your sexual life with, I would say you need to find another one, because you should be able to sit down with your doctor and talk about everything, including your sexuality. And, you know, making sure all things are working well, and working the way you want them to, and be able to ask those questions about why does this do this and why can't I do this anymore? Whatever it is, you know, ask those questions to your doctor. It's so important, and it can make such a big difference in your relationship with your husband, with your significant other. So yeah, have those conversations. And I think it is important that we do have doctors that understand us as African Americans. So if you have a doctor that is not interested in understanding our culture, not interested in knowing about, you know, who we are, who you are as a person, as an African American person, then yeah, I would encourage you to find another doctor.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And then another thing I want to underscore, just only because she raises it into to the point we made earlier in the conversation, Alexis, she and her husband in North Carolina, and she states in her comment here that they've been married for 5 years now, mm-hmm. and they only now are able to have these kinds of conversations. And so let me, one, applaud that.
Yay.
Let me applaud that.
Go, girl. That's really awesome. Five years.
Let me applaud that. To say the fact that you can have the conversations, that's going to ensure healthy next 5, next 10, next 15, next 20
yep.
years. Because if you start the conversation now and continue it, you'll get to that intersection they call the 7-year itch, mm-hmm. and the 7-year itch won't ever impact you. That's number one. And then number two, just to the point of just encouraging others in whatever stage you find your relationship in, is that you got to give your relationship time, space, and nutrition to grow. And every aspect has to grow, and they have to grow in harmony. If you notice, you know, our feet grow, but our feet grow when, you know, our legs are getting taller and our bodies are getting bigger. Our heads should grow at the same rate as our neck. And You know, our shoulders should be able to hold up this head and this neck.
Torso,
the only
right.
thing, the only thing that doesn't seem to want to cooperate is the way these bellies grow. Mm. You know, because I just wish they would stop. But anyway, moving right along. And I agree with you in that the fruit bowl should be good to the last grape. It should be good to the last grape. Grape. Yep. And that timepiece, woo, time, it waits for no one, but it is most valuable to everyone. Mm-hmm. And so that's why I live by this. We don't have time to waste.
It's not a dress rehearsal.
And you have to fire procrastination. Right. Treat procrastination like a criminal. Treat procrastination like a criminal. And, you know, sometimes you just have to say, you know, if it's got to be a quickie, get a quickie. You got to have a quick fruit bowl, have a quick fruit, because time, don't let procrastination rob you, because procrastination is a criminal. Amen. I'm appreciating all the young people we have
Me
on
too.
With us tonight, single people. And I'm glad to be of entertainment to you, Jaleesa. We appreciate you. And you can send me a thank you card anytime you want. I've added mm-hmm. years to
when
your
you
life.
Get married, yes.
Just, marry hard. It's like a it's absolutely. Like medicine. Adding years to your life. Amen. Amen. All right. You got anything? What's going on? What's going on out there? You know, it's not what you post that you have to be concerned about. It's how we respond to it, because y'all never know what I may say. You know, my mother almost dropped
me. She
said
me. That's a fruit snack.
Quickie is a fruit snack. All right. That's okay. Why. That's that. There you go. There you
that's
go.
Good.
There you
that's
go.
Good.
Quickie is a fruit snack. There you go. It'll keep you until you have time to, you know, get the fruit out the pineapple and peel the bananas and slice right. the strawberries and rinse off the grapes and scoop up the cantaloupe with the little melon scooper and
right.
make it look pretty and cut the watermelon into a basket, you know, because sometimes you got to have, you know, at the anniversary, you lay the spread out.
Not just the anniversary.
And then other times you just spread. Anyway, moving right along.
Not just the anniversary. No.
All right, Pastor Ty. Pastor Tyrone said thank you. All right. You're welcome.
So, I mean, and all this came from a commercial, you know? And I told you it would be a good conversation.
A good conversation, yeah. It's a good conversation.
A good conversation.
Yes,
it's a necessary one.
Yes. It's a necessary one. Okay. Yeah, we can.
Y'all are taking me out. I'm just saying, Alexis, it's not just the
anniversary. No, we're not taking you out, Alexis. We're trying to help you to understand that next weekend, you hubby needs to get a babysitter and he should take you out.
Oh, I'm sure they do that.
Right.
Okay, goodbye, Dante Speaks. I'm done with you. I'm done with you. Lord, waiting on my fruit bowl season. Yes.
Chrissy, don't worry about it. Your fruit
coming.
Bowl season
is coming.
It's coming.
It's around the corner.
What commercial? I must not have seen it. Who's
Trina?
That? Trina
Look
Ross.
It up, Trina.
Trina, it's a Dole commercial
Dole
with the grandparents.
Fruit bowls.
That
so
says
sweet.
We're not having no fruit bowls, are we? We're not having no fruit. We eating a lot of fruit bowls.
We just not
but
having.
We're not having a lot of fruit bowls.
Right, because the baby girl wants to eat the fruit bowls, so they're eating the fruit bowls with their granddaughter, but they ain't having fruit bowls. That's their cold.
For their grandparents' special time. That's their code
right,
word.
Right. So as
it's your birthday next weekend, that's right. And so
yes,
so get a babysitter. Go get a babysitter. Go out to dinner
and have some fruit bowls.
I don't know how y'all doing it in North Carolina, but it's probably still warm, so you can sit outside and social distance, and then y'all go walk in the park, and then y'all can go have some fruit bowls and fruit bowls. Okay.
Before we put the music on, just want to. Just say happy anniversary to our son and daughter. This is their first anniversary. This is their anniversary weekend. Can't believe it.
Happy anniversary, Durant and DeAndre. They're not watching tonight because
they're away for their first anniversary. It's their first anniversary
and,
as a married couple. It's
this,
amazing.
This time last year, because the 4th was on a Friday last year.
Yes. Yeah, so
and at this literally, hour, literally, we were partying back at a reception. They were getting it in.
Right.
Yeah, that was a glorious night, a very, very high
so happy
time
anniversary to them.
For our families.
And then every time we're going to talk about it. Just don't forget to vote, register, get your absentee ballots, do what you have to do, because this election is so important. It's critical. Please.
And if that partner of yours, that spouse of yours is one of those that's talking about stuff, I don't need to vote because it's a waste of time. Mm-hmm. The system is broken.
Lottie-dottie, everybody.
Tell them that until they vote, they can't get no more fruit bowls.
There you go.
There shouldn't be no more fruit bowls until you go vote. And if we have a repeat of this 45th chapter,
Jesus,
you ain't never getting no more fruit bowls.
I ain't saying all that. But Jesus knows. I'm probably going to need fruit bowls all the time. I mean, like every single day if we have to live with this man.
I don't know how to respond to that, Alexis.
What?
My husband said he don't do fruit bowls. He want the whole basket.
Okay, fruit basket. That's fine. You say fruit basket, we say fruit bowl.
In y'all house, y'all speak y'all
exactly.
language.
Exactly.
I
love that.
The language of the Crenshaws, y'all don't call it fruit bowls. Y'all call it fruit baskets.
Okay, I'm loving it.
Tell him eat some all the fruit
call it
in the
fruit
basket.
Cup. Some people say fruit snack. Some whatever your thing is.
We not doing no fruit. We not doing no fruit snacks.
I like fruit salad.
I'm too big of a dude for a snack. Snacks don't hold me long. When you running for president, Bishop, you can miss me with that foolishness.
And miss me, honey. I don't want
miss
nobody.
Me with that.
I'm already the first lady
by
of the Grand Emanuel Faith Temple.
By the time they
enough.
Finish. By the time they finish digging up videos of things I have said across the years, y'all think Barack Obama had problems with Jeremiah Wright, y'all will be like, oh, no, no, let's put him back in silent pro. Let's put him back over here because
baskets have handles. I can't stand Dante speaks. Vote. Please go vote.
And you have just a few days. I think October 5th is the deadline for the census. If you have not completed your census
please do so.
Our communities need your representation, need you to list everybody in your home, even your cousin that came to hide at your house from up in New York and they've been hiding there. Put them down because we need the money for roads and bridges and books and computers and other services in our communities. And one of the things that we've got to be very careful about, we have to be very careful about, is neglecting our responsibility civically.
Yeah.
And then we pay for it for 10 years. Or in the instance with voting, we neglect our responsibility and then we pay for it for 4 years. And what we can ill afford at this hour is to neglect our responsibility and our right. And if it give you any, and I know I'm probably preaching to the choir at this point, I'm talking to people who are tenacious in their practice, but trust me, if it is any more an impetus for you, your grandparents and great grandparents, my great grandparents, their blood was spilled so that we could have the right to cast a vote. Do not let their sacrifices and their lives be lost in vain because we fumbled the ball at this intersection. Trust me, 40 days from now, less than 40 days from now,
glory to God.
We need a change in this nation. And let me just say it this way, and then I'm done for the night. This is the only preach y'all gonna get out of me tonight. While I am prayerfully asking God for mercy for Donald Trump. Do not allow this right here to blur the lines of all that we have lived through for the last 3 years and 10 months. Our nation is in abysmal condition right now. The kind of tensions that we have between communities, the level of unemployment, the disenfranchisement of people of color, and then dare I say the delusionment in people's minds right now is at an all-time high. He talks about make America great again. I think that what he really meant to say was my aim and goal is make America hate again. And we need to show our fellow citizens that not only are we awake, we are active. And not only are we active, we will not accept anything less than a diverse, equally affirming community for every man and woman under the umbrella and rubric of these United States of America. You got me? So yes. If you don't do anything, and I pray now that you don't vote, God will trouble your sleep, give you insomnia that not even pills would even solve. God to trouble you.
Get your kids, the 18.
People that don't vote, I want you to have boils up your back and eczema. Okay. And 10 other things.
Go vote, please. Jesus.
At this hour, because we can make a difference. And we're standing with the National Action Network, and we're declaring that at no less than 75% of our community will vote. Remember, when Barack Obama won his second term, he had 69% of the African American community's vote. And we can do it again.
We can.
The goal of the National Action Network is 75%. Let's make sure that in our houses, everyone that is of voting age cast their ballot. Yes. And if you got to do it early, get up and do it early. But whatever you do, get it done.
Get it done.
I know that had nothing to do with fruit bowls, but every platform we have, we will be talking about fruit bowl. I mean, talking about voting and census. Because we're going to have good fruit bowls in the weeks to come.
Especially on November 4th. Listen.
Celebrate. Well, thank you for joining us for Late Night with the Harvins one more time. It's been a great hour spent with you.
It's been awesome.
Cue the music, DJ. It's time for us to bid everybody a good night. Remember, we love you, but God loves you best.
Yes,
and there's no night like a late night with the Harvins. Good night.
Good night.
Good night, Shauna.
Hey, Shauna.
Tell my deacon I said, hey.
Love him.
We coming to North Carolina. I think weekend after next, we coming down to see Lisa's aunt. Is it weekend after next?
I think so.
We coming down to see our aunt. So we're going to stop through to see y'all. They live in Raleigh. Well, outside of Raleigh.
Yep. So we'll see you then.
All right.
Bye, everyone.
Oh, Tootie giving y'all bad gas if y'all don't vote. All right. Love you. Good night. Love to the Zimmermans. Good night, Pastor and First Lady Z. We love you.
Have a great weekend.
Be good. We trying to hang up, but it won't.
It won't let us.
It won't let us. They keep giving us.